Hello everyone, welcome my dear 8th class students. So here is your Mamta miss, okay, going to teach today part 4 of your civics chapter 1, the Union Legislature, okay, about the Parliament of India. So let us have now the recapitulation of the previous class. So here we go with the recapitulation. The Indian Parliament, which is located in New Delhi, consists of two houses, the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. The Lok Sabha is the lower house of the Parliament and the house of the people. It can have a maximum of 552 members envisaged by our constitution. The members of the Lok Sabha are directly elected by the people of the country who are 18 years or above. They are elected via the general elections, which are generally held after every 5 years. Certain qualifications are necessary to become a member of the Lok Sabha. After the results of a general election, the leader of the political party which wins the maximum number of seats in the elections is asked to form the government by the president. This is the recap of your previous class. So now, my dear students, let us begin the remaining portion of your chapter. So here we go. As previous class, we have learned about the Lok Sabha. Now let us read about the speaker. Okay. So just go through your textbook, all of you. The Speaker is the presiding officer of the Lok Sabha. The proceedings of the Lok Sabha, the maintenance of discipline, the duty of impartially conducting the business of the House, irrespective of the political party, rests on the Speaker. The Speaker is elected by all the members of the House. In the absence of the Speaker, the Deputy Speaker conducts the business of the House. The Deputy Speaker is also elected by the members of the House. So Ganesh V. Malvankar was the first speaker of the Lok Sabha. So my dear students, so here you know the main point is that speaker is the presiding officer of the Lok Sabha. He is the main member of the parliament. Okay, he is the main member of the parliament. Okay, the office of the speaker occupies a pivotal position in our parliamentary democracy. He is the presiding officer of the Lok Sabha. And speaker presides the meetings and sessions of Lok Sabha. So speaker and the deputy speaker are elected among the members of Lok Sabha. Okay, so you know that, and this speaker, if he wants to resign, okay, if he wants to resign, then he has to give the resignation. Suppose he wants to resign in some ill health conditions, okay, so he has to give the resignation to the deputy speaker, and if deputy speaker wants the same, he also has to give the resignation to the speaker. Okay, so here the speaker is elected by all the members of the house, and in the absence of the speaker, the deputy speaker conducts the business of the house, the work of the meetings of the house. Okay, the deputy speaker is also elected by the members of the house. So my dear students, this is all about the speaker. Okay, so now, can you tell me who is the present speaker of Lok Sabha? Yes, you are seeing here the picture. And who is this? Can you tell me? And present speaker of Lok Sabha is who? Mr. Om Birla, isn't it? Om Birla is an Indian politician who is the 17th and current speaker of the Lok Sabha. He serves a member of parliament for the Kota Bundi constituency in Rajasthan. He belongs to Bharatiya Janata Party. Okay, this is all about the speaker of Lok Sabha, the present speaker of the Lok Sabha. Now, let us go move towards the next phase, that is your Rajya Sabha. Okay, the next, the another house of the parliament, that is Rajya Sabha. The Rajya Sabha is the upper house of the Parliament of India. It is also called the Council of States. Okay, Rajya Sabha is called upper house and also called Council of States. Unlike the Lok Sabha, it is a permanent house. That means it cannot be dissolved, okay? It is a permanent. The members to this house are indirectly elected by the adult citizens of the country. So here, the members of this house, they are indirectly elected by the adult citizens. Do you know, my dear, how they are elected? Let us know this. So composition, you see, the Rajya Sabha has a maximum strength of 250 members. How many members? 250 members. In Lok Sabha, how many members you have? 552. But here you have 250 members. Out of the 250 members, 12 are nominated by the president of the country. These are those people who have excelled in various fields such as art, science, literature, social service, etc. The rest 238 members are elected by the members of the various state legislative assemblies. So my dear, in Lok Sabha, how the members were elected? How the members are elected? The members were given to the whom? To the states, union territories and by the president. Isn't it? But here, the members of Rajya Sabha are not elected by the common people. They are not elected by the common people. Here, they are elected by whom? They are elected by the various state legislative assemblies. That means, here they are elected by, suppose now we have the MLAs in every state. Those from those MLAs, they will be selected for the member of Rajya Sabha. Okay, and here you can see, as I told you, out of 250 members here, okay, so 238 are elected, 238 are given for the states and the union territories, and here out of 238, 12 are nominated by the president. And how they are nominated? The persons, those who are excelled, very skillful, very intelligent in the field of art, science, literature or social service, if president finds that, for an example, Sachin Tendulkar, okay, Sachin Tendulkar, who is he? He is a cricketer, isn't it? And he is excel in cricket field. He is a very skillful player in cricket. So here president wants him. Now president wants him to make the members of Rajya Sabha, isn't it not? So he is the member of Rajya Sabha also. Now you can take another example. Rekha, she is what? She is an actress, very excellent actress in the field of films. So as she is going also in the film industry, so in that case she also a member of Rajya Sabha. Same way MF Hussain is a great painter, isn't it, going in the field of painting, so in that case he also will be elected as a member of the Rajya Sabha. Same way here, those who are excel in different fields, the president feel that yes, this person is very skillful in such fields, so he will nominate. So here the president nominates 12 members of his own choice, okay? The members of the Rajya Sabha represent the different states and union territories of India. Notably, the number of members representing a state or union territory depends on the population of the state or the union territory. For instance, since Uttar Pradesh is the most populous state of the country, the maximum number of members to the Rajya Sabha are elected from this state. Yes, the members, those who are elected from the states, it depends upon the population of the particular state. For an example given here, the Uttar Pradesh, the most populous state of the country. So here, number of members will be elected from this particular state. It has been stated before that the Rajya Sabha is a permanent house. This means this house cannot be dissolved, okay? Because you know that Lok Sabha dissolves after every 5 years, but this is permanent house. It cannot be dissolved. 1/3 of the members retire after every 2 years. That means the members, those are present 250 members. Out of 250 members, 1/3 of its members retire after every 2 years and are replaced by new members. So when these 1/3 members retire, then again new members are elected to the Rajya Sabha. And every member of the house is elected for a term of 6 years. That means for 6 years they are elected. Okay, now what is the eligibility criteria to be the member of Rajya Sabha? That means certain qualifications are required, isn't it? So like the Lok Sabha, to become a member of the Rajya Sabha, a person should have certain qualifications. How to be a member of Lok Sabha, certain qualifications needed. Same way for getting the seat for Rajya Sabha also, certain qualifications are necessary. They are as follows: should be an Indian national, Indian citizen should be 30 years of age or above, should be mentally sound, should not be a proclaimed offender, should not have any crime in his life, and should not be insolvent, should not hold any office or profit under the government, means should not be a government job holder, should have his or her name in the electoral list in any part of the country. So in any voter list also he should has his own name, otherwise he cannot be elected for the Rajya Sabha. Okay, so you can see here snippet is given here. The parliament building was designed by whom? Sir Edwin de Lutyens and Sir Herbert Baker. It was formally inaugurated by then Governor General Lord Irvine on January 18, 1927. So my dear students, so this is all about the two houses of the parliament that we have read. Okay, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, and the main speaker of the Lok Sabha. So these are the two houses we have discussed. Now I hope so you are clear about the parliament. So in my next video we'll go for the functions of the parliament and next the remaining part of the chapter. Okay my dear, so thank you, God bless you.